and I am the attorney and friend of the Jackson family. They have asked me to read this statement on their behalf. There's no way to adequately describe the loss of our beloved father, son, brother, and friend. We still look each other in disbelief. Is it really possible that he is gone? As Michael's parents, we could never have imagined that we would live to witness his passing. It is simply against the natural order of things. As his brothers and sisters, we will never be able to hold, laugh, or perform again with our brother Michael. And as his children, we will grow up without a father, our best friend, our playmate, and our dad. We are not here to seek revenge. There is nothing you can do today that will bring Michael back. But we will keep the love in our hearts that Michael embodied throughout his life. His passion was for unifying the world through the gift of his artistry. We respectfully request that you impose a sentence that reminds physicians that they cannot sell their services to the highest bidder and cast aside their Hippocratic oath to do no harm.
He does not feel guilty because he did not do anything wrong. Even at that point, weeks into the trial, years into the filing of the case, Dr. Murray indicated for all to see he did nothing wrong. And I'd ask the court to consider that in determining what appropriate prison sentence to impose. I would also ask the court to consider the statements of Michael Jackson's mother. Mrs. Jackson related that all of the family members feel angry and betrayed by the defendant, that not a day goes by when she does not think about her son, that all of her children and all of her son's children think about Michael daily. She noted that every morning he is the first thing she thinks about. Michael Jackson was his children's world, and their world collapsed when he left. While at the hospital on the day of the incident, after Mr. Jackson was pronounced dead, his daughter Paris was crying and stated, "I want to go with you," referring to her dad. Mrs. Jackson relays how Mr. Jackson and his children were making plans to enter the filmmaking industry and to pursue that together as a family project. Mrs. Jackson relays how she was personally offended, as was the rest of the family, when on the one-year anniversary of Michael Jackson's death, Dr. Murray arranged for a camera crew or photographer to accompany him to Michael Jackson's cemetery to be photographed. Mrs. Jackson indicates that the defendant violated her son's trust, failed her son, and failed her family. And Mrs. Jackson asks that the defendant receive the maximum sentence allowed under the law. Your Honor, the people join Mrs. Jackson in asking for the maximum sentence. This case, based on the defendant's own behavior, the defendant's own statements, warrants the maximum sentence, that sentence being 4 years in state prison. That is the just sentence, and that is the sentence we ask this court to impose along with the requested restitution as the court deems appropriate.
We do not disagree with prosecution that this is a tragedy, and what we lost with Michael Jackson and what his children lost certainly demands punishment. I do wonder, though, to what extent the court considers the entirety of a man's book of life as opposed to just one chapter. The 2 months that Dr. Murray was treating Michael Jackson, he did so regrettably. He shouldn't have done it. But when we talk about vulnerability, we're going to be honest about vulnerability. Michael Jackson was a drug seeker. and he sought it out from Dr. Murray, who was wrong in providing it. He sought it out from other doctors. He was a powerful, famous, wealthy individual with lawyers and security and staff and advisors. He can do things for the community on probation that he could never do sitting in that little room. And I don't know what the point of punishment is, what you think it is, but I think it's what's best for the community. I think that's what needs to be looked at. And I don't see how prison would do that.
The fact that a jury of 12 people from remarkably different backgrounds and life experiences concluded unanimously and beyond a reasonable doubt that Dr. Murray had, with criminal negligence, caused the death of Michael Jackson. It's important to emphasize the standard of criminal negligence found by this jury beyond a reasonable doubt, because some may feel this was a medical malpractice case. It wasn't. It was and is a criminal homicide case. And this jury found beyond a reasonable doubt that the defendant, with criminal negligence, caused the death of Michael Jackson. The court has determined that the appropriate term is the high term of 4 years imprisonment. I do so because, once again, I find that Dr. Murray abandoned his patient who was trusting him. His patient was vulnerable under those circumstances, having been administered potentially dangerous drugs by his medical provider. Dr. Murray's course of conduct extended over a period of time. Dr. Murray repeatedly lied, engaged in deceitful misconduct, and endeavored to cover up his transgressions. He violated the trust of the medical community, of his colleagues, and of his patient. And he has absolutely no sense of remorse. Dr. Murray was intrigued by the prospect, and he engaged in this money for medicine madness that is simply not going to be tolerated by me. So as to sentencing in this case, the request for probation is denied. The court imposes the high term of 4 years imprisonment in this case. Pursuant to the Realignment Act of 2011 and the provisions of Penal Code Section 1170, Subdivision H, that four-year sentence is to be served in the Los Angeles County Jail under the care, supervision, and direction of the Los Angeles County Sheriff.